27, reading from the New King James Version, Psalm number 27. When you found it, you will discover these words. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked came against me to eat up my flesh, my enemies and my foes, they stumbled and fell. Though an army may encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing I desire of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, and behold the beauty of the Lord, and inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his provision. In the secret place of his tabernacle, he shall hide me. He shall set me high upon a rock. Father God in heavens, in the name of Jesus the Christ, we come. Lord, we thank you again. For Lord, you have surely done it again. Lord, we thank you for just being good and being God. We say hallowed to your name, for you're worthy of all the honor, all the praise, and all the glory. God, you're worthy, Father God, for you alone are God. There is none like you. We adore you. We love you. We praise you. We honor you, Father. God, we thank you for another chance just to come into your presence, Lord. We thank you for another opportunity, Father God, just to call on your holy name. We thank you, Lord, for all that you are, all that you've been, and Lord, what you're going to be. We thank you, Father God, for sparing us. And we realize, Lord, we are not worthy. We realize that we missed the mark. We realize that we've fallen short. And Lord, we thank you for forgiving us. We ask you, Father God, for forgiving us today for our sins. Bless us, Father God, that we will hear from you today. We pray, Father God, that you bless us, feed us this morning through your word, Father God. Hold up the man of God, that life will be made to differ, that we will be better at 1 o'clock than we were at 10 o'clock. That we will run and tell men, women, boys, and girls about the God we serve and how he's made a way out of no way. Lord, keep us doing this service, Father God, that your Holy Spirit will lead, guide, direct, and protect us. That your Holy Spirit will have free rule, Father God, that your Holy Spirit will walk throughout these buildings. That your Holy Spirit, Father God, will teach us and instruct us. Now, Lord, we pray that you bless us as we hear and bless us as we leave this place, that we will run and tell men, women, boys, and girls about the goodness of Jesus Christ and what he has already done for us. Now, Lord, we ask you to keep the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. Allow us to be beneficiaries of your many blessings. It's in the strong, mighty, powerful, anointed name of Jesus Christ, the Christ of God. The Christ who died for us. The Christ who rose for us. It's in the name of Jesus the Christ we pray. And we ask it all. In Jesus' name. Amen.
To the best of my soul. Bye.
thank you all again, and we pray that you will join in with us as we continue to uplift the name of Jesus. Our next song is "For the Rest of My Life, I Will Serve the Lord." Now that's what I'm gonna do. What am I gonna do? For the rest of my life, I'm going to serve the Lord.
I am prepared to serve him and him alone.
I don't know.
Today we are breaking our custom. In the month of January, we always are in a month of prayer, and I know you've been in this month of prayer and fasting.
Yes, Lord.
And the custom has been that I always preach the whole month of January, and there's never a guest. But when your older brother come to town,
Amen.
I said, when your older brother comes to town, an older brother who has a word from the Lord, don't get stuck in tradition. Allow God to speak and rule and super rule.
Yes,
all the way from Kansas City, Missouri.
Amen.
My older brother, Pastor Eric Belt from the great St. Stephen's Missouri Baptist Church. It is this preacher who oftentimes stood on the church property to 12, 2 o'clock in the morning with myself.
All right.
And we shared the word of God. We didn't have anything to drink, anything to eat. We just stood on the property of the Holman Street Church. Long after church was over, people were gone home, communion had been served. But we would continue to edify each other in the word of God to 12, 2 o'clock in the morning.
Amen.
Standing on the property, just talking about the goodness of God, sharing the word of God. He's made a valuable impression on my life. He's my older brother. He's a minister in all his right. He's a preacher. I have never told him this, but doing my graduate studies for my master's, it's because of how well he led in Christian education that I chose to go into Christian education as an emphasis for my master.
Amen.
It is because of the impression that he's made on my life and shown me how serious men of the word ought to be about the word of God.
Right.
That now I'm serious about the word. In all of our conversations, even on the phone call, our wives begin to look upside our heads when we begin to preach to each other, even on the phone and holler back at each other, go ahead, preacher. It is a kindred spirit that I have with not many others, but it's because this man is serious about the word of God.
Amen.
He's my older brother, so he teaches me, he instructs me, and he helps me to come continuously to the pulpit and preach the word of God. If you would, stand to your feet and welcome my elder brother, Pastor Eric Bell, pastor of the St. Stephen's Missionary Baptist Church, Kansas City, Missouri. Seeing folks in worship. It's I never thought a day would come.
Amen.
And church would be closed. I never thought that would ever happen. And so it's such a privilege to be in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
With my brother, my sister, First Lady Davis. Call him Matthew, but no respect, Pastor. I thank you for the invitation. I'm okay with parking lot preaching. I get nervous when I come in. I ask that you pray with me. My mother is going through a little situation in the areas of stages of dementia. Couldn't see her now. And I never traveled without my wife, and mother-in-law was with me, and I had to leave and get here. But she's out of the hospital, she's home.
Praise God.
Praise God.
So I pray I don't cry while I'm going through it, because I'm human too. Just thank you for this opportunity. Pastor, because he's my brother, my friend, he asked me to bring my saxophone, knowing he had a saxophone is already here. So I'm nervous because there's already saxophones in the house. So I'm gonna try to do a little bit there, and he said I could just have my way, so I'm nervous, I'm shaking, and so just let me have my way. I want to thank this choir for blessing us with praise. You can't see folks like I'm used to, the expression of their faces, so I don't know if you're frowning, or you're mad, or you're happy. But I want to go with what I just heard when I came in. It says, come let us worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Completely yes. My soul says yes.
Yes, sir.
And Claude said, for the rest of my life, I serve.
Yeah, all right now.
I don't have nothing else to say. Yeah. He, sweet, I. thank you for allowing us to come to the house of prayer to praise your name. Thank you, Lord, for what our eyes have seen, what our ears have heard, Lord. We pray, Father, that even in the midst of your people, that you, Father, will bless us now. Take us out of self, Lord. Anoint us from the top of our head. Stir up our hearts, Lord, to praise your name. Put us now, Lord, in the atmosphere to praise your name, Father, to hear your word. Have your way, Father, in this place. Oh, Lord, and we'll be careful to give you praise. If there's somebody here who don't know you, Lord, have not accepted you, have not received, Father, I ask you, Lord, have your way in this place. We'll be careful to give you praise. It is in your name, Father, we ask. It is in your name, Lord, we praise you. It is in your name, Lord, we come and honor you. It's in Jesus' name we ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. wife assisting me.
Amen.
For those who accompanied me. I love that drama. Love that organ. I love music, y'all.
Amen.
Y'all was about to make me act up. I'm about to preach. Daniel 4th chapter.
All right now.
I read from the English Standard Version, several versions. I love Good News Translation, so there'll be some scripture that I'll be saying good news. And then there might be one I'll be saying from King James. So I like the word of God.
All right.
But it all gonna come from the Bible.
That's right. Let them know.
I'll be a little lengthy. I'm not going to read the whole, but I need to read a summary of it. Start at the 28th verse, the 4th chapter of Daniel. It's in the middle of the story. 28 says, and all this came upon King Nebuchadnezzar. 29 says, at the end of 12 months, he was walking on the roof of his royal palace of Babylon. 30 said, and the king answered and said, is not this great Babylon, which I have built by my mighty power as a royal residence and for the glory of my majesty? 31 says, while the words were still in the king's mouth,
All right.
There fell a voice from heaven. O King Nebuchadnezzar, to you it is spoken. The kingdom has departed from you. You shall be driven from among men. Your dwelling shall be with the beasts of the field. You shall be made to eat grass like an ox. 7 periods of time shall pass over you until you know that the Most High rules the kingdom of men and gives it to whom he will. 33 says, immediately the word was fulfilled against Nebuchadnezzar. He was driven from among men and ate grass like an ox. And his body was wet, the dew of heaven, till his hair grew long as eagle's feathers, and his nails were like bird claws. 34 says, the 4th chapter, verse 34 says, at the end of the day, I, Nebuchadnezzar, lift up my eyes to heaven.
Yeah.
And my reason returned to me. And I bless the Most High and praise and honor him who lives forever. For his dominion is an everlasting dominion, and his kingdom endured from generation to generation. 35 says, and all the inhabitants of the earth are counted as nothing, and he does according to his will among the host of heaven and among the inhabitants of the earth, and none can stay his hands or say to him, what have I done? 36 says, at the same time, my reason returned to me. For the glory of my kingdom, my majesty and splendor returned to me. My counselors and my Lord sought me, and I was establishing my kingdom. And still more greatness was added to me. Final verse says, now I Nebuchadnezzar.
Amen.
I feel like I read it again. I Nebuchadnezzar.
All right now.
Praise. And exalt.
Yes.
And honor.
All right now.
The King of heaven.
Yes.
For all his works are right.
Yes, Lord.
And his ways are just.
Yes.
And those who walk in pride,
all right now,
is able.
Yes.
to humble.
That's right.
Yes, Lord.
That God had a blessing to the reader, to the hearer, and doer of his holy word.
All right now.
I want to use for a subject. First lady came to me. Lord, I'm available.
All right.
To you.
All right.
All right
now. All right. Lord,
I'm available to you.
I'm available. I'm available to.
All right now.
To you.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
This passage in what was read to you, perhaps none of us know Nebuchadnezzar. But Nebuchadnezzar was a difficult king who had power.
Yes, sir.
Perhaps none of us may, in a sense, see ourselves as king. But in all right, all of us sometimes act as kings in our own right. Just to bring us up to where we are. As king, Nebuchadnezzar, this is his second dream. His first dream was, Nebuchadnezzar said, tell me what I dream. And if you don't tell me what I dream, you'll be put to death. I know the fourth chapter said, we're going to get there, he was insane. That sounds like an insane man already. Think about it. Somebody come to you and tell me, I had a dream last night. Tell me what I dream. Now I'm going to bless you if you tell me. But if you don't tell me what I dream, I'm going to put you to death.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Do that sound like insane version to you? I'm not here to preach that, but believe it or not, when Daniel found out what was going on, Daniel sought the Lord and said, Lord, have mercy.
Yes, Lord.
Only you can help me.
Yes.
And God did.
You're right.
But that's not what I'm here to preach about.
Tell us.
See, after Nebuchadnezzar witnessed the power of God and the man of God, being a woman too.
Amen.
I hope I'm all right here for y'all, because God works to everybody.
Amen.
That's right.
Right.
You would think he would have realized something, because it takes divine power to reveal that kind of discernment.
Yes, sir.
But that didn't do it for him. So another thing happened to him in chapter 3. He built this statue and said,
it's not in the Bible, but the saxophone was playing.
When the musical instruments play,
yes,
the partial one. When you hear the sound, amen, bow down.
Yes.
Lord,
preach it, man. Three boys, Shadrach, Meshach. Y'all know I'm going to add stuff to it, a bad Negro. Excuse me.
Yeah.
A Bendigo. Better be careful. They're at home. They wouldn't bow down, and because they wouldn't, it was reported. The boys he put in position when their music sounded, in honor of your boys, and he was extremely angry.
Yes, sir.
Gave them another chance.
Yes.
And they wouldn't bow down.
He said, and he, the furnace up, seven times high.
Yes, sir.
Bible says, and throw him in.
Preach
it, man. Preach it. They throw him in. And the next day he rose to his feet. And he questioned. Did not we throw three in?
Yes, sir.
But he sees four. Yes, Lord. All right.
But I see four.
All right, man.
And out of his mouth, he said, and the fourth one.
And the fourth one.
I know three, but the fourth one looks like. Son of the
Lord.
Right.
I know he's a priest. That's a good preacher right there.
Yeah.
Hey!
Say that.
30 years later, he seen God reveal his dream and God's messenger. And he seen God bring, Lord have mercy. Those he tried to destroy through a fiery furnace.
Yes, yes.
He received something.
Yes. Yes, sir.
For 30 years, sometimes the pandemic comes through.
Yes, Lord.
We get to watching church at home.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Not used to fellowship then. We forget the blessings of God. We become comfortable. So when we get to praise God, we just so comfortable in God's house, as if God's doing something for us.
Say it.
We forget how to praise God.
Yes, Lord.
How to acknowledge God.
Yeah. Say that.
Yes, another dream. We read halfway through. Cut to the chase, come the time is gone. He said, Nebuchadnezzar, if he called for Daniel. If you don't repent, come to your senses. The Lord is going to take all that you have.
Yes,
and even you, with all this you think you have, you're going to find yourself away from your kingdom on all fours like an animal. Claws on your fingernails growing out.
Amen.
Like an animal, your hair will fall down, so forth. But in the seventh year,
all right.
Oh Lord, if you lift your head up to heaven,
yes.
And call on the name of Jesus,
yes.
God will take it away.
Yes.
I just want to start right there. I'm really almost through.
Huh.
But I want to deal with this just a little bit and then I'll celebrate.
Uh-huh.
I discovered that that things can happen around you, such as what's around you. Things can happen in a sense that you can witness with your eyes. Perhaps not the same event, but God bringing someone through a fiery furnace. You can be present. You can witness and you can acknowledge in your mouth that there is a God.
Yes,
God.
Yes.
And still not believe.
All right.
Can I say it one more time?
All right.
Yes.
You can go to church. You can. You can participate in our auxiliary.
Right, right.
You can say, I know there's a God.
All right now.
It comes out of your mouth. You can see it with your eyes.
Right.
But yet, deep in your heart.
Yeah.
It's not me judging you, but you know you really ain't there where you need to be. And still.
Yes.
Not believe.
That's right.
Seven. Not only things can happen around you, but things can, they can happen to you.
Oh,
yeah. This wasn't part of the sermon, but, I may hurt somebody today.
Oh, come on.
I'm living a time also I never thought that folks
know they died if they don't get the shot.
Mm-hmm.
Let me let it roll.
No, go ahead.
Reach it.
I scratch my head. They say, you know how many folks done died from not having the shot?
Yeah. My Lord.
Folks still don't want it. Still playing around as if it don't exist.
That's right.
So things can happen. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. Baby, let me get in a little more personal. You know, folks say, I had it, but I got through. You got through that time.
Huh.
Well, I wish I could tell somebody, but how many people you gave it through? Let me leave it alone. I better stop right now. Things can happen to you.
Yes.
You lose your job. Lose your house, you can lose your family. You can lose all your income. You can lose your mind. But there's something on the inside that says, I know there's a God, but because you don't believe, not call on Him. Nebuchadnezzar walked out on his patio, sitting on his roof. Because God had blessed him, he didn't know who blessed him. Look what I've done. Yeah, God will hear me. So I know some of us guilty. Some of us say that's my car, that's my house, that's my children. Boy, I ain't gonna mess with you right now. But you done said that's my. But all of it belongs to God. Today was your day. Today was never today's day. He said, look what I've done. And as he said it out of his mouth, amen, a voice from him, he didn't even expect it. Hey, y'all hear me? He didn't send no prophet. God said, right now.
That's right.
You've been warned. You've been told. But right now, it shall be fulfilled.
Yeah.
What'd that look like? You got dressed for church this morning. You was feeling fine.
All right.
Yesterday, you in your right mind. But in the twinkling of an eye, ain't nobody hit you. Ain't nobody slapping you in fail. Ain't nothing happened. Just in the twinkling of an eye, all of a sudden you found you couldn't speak. You in your mind, you left your, oh Lord, you just all of a sudden, just like, can I help somebody right now? Amen. You may be in your right mind right now, but you better thank God you ain't your right mind. You ain't wake yourself up this morning.
Yeah. All right now.
What am I saying? I want to thank the Lord for a portion.
Yes. A portion
of health and strength that I'm still. Your grandma didn't pray that prayer.
Right.
Still in my right mind.
Say that.
You're right.
Matthew, I didn't know how long I had, but I didn't choose to use this subject because I've been all day. And y'all probably follow with my title, but I wanted to say insane for Christ. That might have been too much there. And I'm going to tell you why I thought about that. Because he was insane. He had a mental breakdown. He was sick. He didn't cut his hair. Hair was growing. Nails were long. He was out with animals.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Oh, I'm coming. Let me stop right there. You don't think that could happen to you, do you?
Yes, it can.
I know about it.
Yes.
Because you can't imagine that happening to you. You think that's an old person.
No.
But God wanted to show you something.
Yeah.
God wants, this is about knowing one's pride.
Yes.
He took everything from him.
Yeah.
But here's where the subject come from. Subject come from. But he had to remember.
Yes, Lord.
In the 70s, if you call on God.
Yes, Lord. Say that.
You
probably don't see what I'm saying yet. Some of us can't remember it's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Mm. All right.
It's January what?
All right.
In your right mind.
All right now.
But the scripture says that that same person can remember the 7 years. What happened to the part that after 7 years went by? Amen. He had a decision to make. Let's see back. But he had to remember what Daniel said. What happened in that 7 year? I could talk about one. What happened? Did he reflect in his insane mind how good God is? Tell you what happened.
Tell us.
It wasn't what was happening around him.
All right now.
It really wasn't what happened to him.
Okay now.
Sickness wise.
I see it.
But when he decided, he didn't need the White House to tell him what to do. He didn't need somebody else stuttering. I think they said it like this. This is my story. This is my, it got personal. I'm praising my Savior. When he got to the point that he was going to believe God for himself.
Yes, say that.
A change took place.
My Lord.
I say this song is not the one, but I never paid attention to this song. But listen to these words. A change has come
over me.
Listen to this. He changed my life. And now I'm free. I mean, he washed away all my sins and he made me whole. He washed me white as snow. He changed my life and now I'm still free. I sit at his feet to do what must be done.
Yeah.
I work and work until he comes. A wonderful change.
Yes, come over me.
Thank
you.
Has come over me.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
I saw the words. But it touched me.
Yes, sir.
Until he changed your life. Until,
yes, Lord.
Until God becomes your God. So God becomes your Savior.
Uh-huh.
hey, things really won't be as the old Bible said. He lifted up his eyes to heaven and called.
All right now.
On the name of the Lord.
Lord.
Now I'm through.
Heavenly God.
Mom got up this morning. Jesus. Said to my dad, don't bother the preacher, you're preaching today.
Amen.
All right now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Amen.
I told you. See you on first stage.
All right now.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes I can't find the bathroom in our own house. Repeat herself a lot over and over.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
This morning she said, hush, Bill.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
The preacher.
Yes.
It's preaching today.
My Lord.
Yes.
Don't yes, bother. Sir. Yes, sir.
Preach, Pastor.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Oh, Lord. Mama said, son, what you preaching today?
Yes.
Lord, I gave you a word.
Yes.
I said, Mama, I'm going to try to talk about a person who was insane. Mm-hmm. But he looked at him.
Mm-hmm.
He said, say what? I say insane, Mama. She said, hi, Reggie. What you gonna preach this morning?
Mm-hmm.
I said, Mama,
What I believe Nebuchadnezzar did or said, I wasn't there, but if I can put it in my own words, you gave me my hand.
All right.
To reach out to man.
All right.
To show him your love and your perfect plan. You gave me my ear. I can hear your voice so clear.
Yes, Lord, have mercy.
I can hear the cries of sinners. I can wipe away their tears.
Yes, Lord.
Preach it, man.
You gave me my voice. To speak your words. To sing all your praise. To those who never heard, but with my eyes,
all right now,
I see a need,
yes, Lord,
for more availability. I can see the heart that has been broken. So many people to be free,
yes, Lord.
Lord,
yes, Lord,
I'm available. To you, my will, I give to you. I do what you say to you. Use me, Lord, to show you the way, and enable me. My storage is to pay. Listen to hear. And now I'm available to you. Man, he looked up to heaven. He looked up to heaven. He said, I'm giving back to you. All of these you gave to me. My hand, my ears, my voice, my eyes, so you can use me as you please. I'm giving up my cup,
yeah,
so that you can still fill me up. Now I'm free. I just wanna be available to you. There's a witness out here, Lord. I'm available to you.
Yeah.
My will, I give to you. I do what you say. Confused, and what I have belongs
I'm available to you.
Chapter 10, verses 9 and 10. If you just believe this story, you shall be saved. The Bible teaches in John 3:16 that if you can believe this story, you can be saved. The Bible teaches in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 that if you believe the story, you will be saved. You will be guaranteed a spot in heaven. The door is open. If you haven't trusted him, just bow your head with me and repeat after me and invite Jesus Christ into your life. Just say, Lord Jesus, I believe that you are the Son of God. I believe that you died for my sins. I believe that you rose from the dead. Now come into my life and make me a new person. Thank you for saving my soul. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen and thank God. Thank God for who he is and what he's all in you. And if you're listening, you're watching, you're sitting, and you're in between church homes, or you're looking for a church home, or you're without a church home, I recommend the New Beginning Church. Where Jesus is the captain of the ship. Where Jesus is the main attraction. Where Jesus is the one who we look to and we depend on. If you're listening to us this morning by broadcast, inbox us and let us know that you want to be a part of the New Beginning Church, and we will rejoice with you and celebrate with you and welcome you to this family of faith. If you receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, let us know so we can rejoice and celebrate what God has done in your life.
Amen.
I told you it was worth it.
Yes, it was.
I told you it was worth it.
Yeah,
all that you've gone through this morning, it was worth the trip.
Yeah.
I told you it was going to be worth it. It was worth breaking the series for my elder brother to come and continue the series.
Come on.
God has blessed us in this place. You want to make yourself available to him. And you want to look at God, acknowledge him, but you also want to turn to him. The preacher made it very clear today. Let us thank God again for the man of God. Hallelujah to the Lord. God has tremendously used you today, my brother. Thank you for coming this way. Thank you for breaking our usual tradition to hear a word from the Lord. Amen. And certainly we've heard a word from the Lord. Hallelujah. It is now offering time. It is now time to give to the Lord. Through tithes, offering, and sacrificial gifts. It is offering time. If you need an envelope, raise your hand, raise it in the air. If you need an envelope, you will be served. If you need an envelope, raise your hand in the air if you need an envelope. The white and red envelope is for pastor's love offering. The white and blue envelope for tithes, offering, and sacrificial gifts. You can choose either one you want or both of them, and you will be served. We ask you to bless every giver and bless every gift. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and thank God. I'm going to ask you to sign.
to stand. While the first impression from the rear, bring forth the Lord's time to offer their sacrificial gifts. Blessings from the rear to the front, bring forth the Lord's tithes, offering and sacrificial gifts. This is getting a little extensive, but we want to call and bombard heaven on behalf of those that are ailing and those that God need to visit. Amen. On our prayer list, we have Charles Powell, Rayshon Merriman, Cassidy Racklin, Reverend Ed Brandon and his wife, Sister Emma Brandon, Ramona Mathis, Nicholas, Lorene Orr, Gary Simon and family, Rosie Davis, Benny M. Tisby, Joe Studivant, Barry's family, Nash Carter, Ron Rucker, Bobby and Betty Funberger, Santiago Melo. We are praying for the Westfield family. In the midst of bereavement, and the Wells family. These are relatives of Sister Lula Richard. We're praying for the prayer warriors, those of you who've been in prayer this whole month. We're praying for soul winners, those who are reaching the world for Jesus Christ. We're praying for Sister Cheryl Barney. We're praying for the elimination of flu and coronavirus.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Let's go before God. Father God, we thank you now. We bless your name, for we know that you're good and you're God. There's none like you. Lord, we know that you are a healer. You are the comforter. You're the God that we look to do all things well. Now, Lord, we pray for these names that we've called. And those that we don't know that hold their troubles in the deep secrets of their hearts. Lord, we ask you to touch us only you can. Heal and comfort as only you can. Move, Lord, as only you can. Bless, Lord, as only you can. Lord, we ask you, Father God, to bless us, to see the manifestation of your presence, that we will give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And thank God. We're looking forward to you and adults bringing in their report cards. Your report cards are due, whether you're on 6 weeks or 9 weeks. We're looking for our youth and our young people, our report cards, and also we're looking for those of you who have evaluations on your job to bring them on in so we can lift them before the Lord in prayer. We are celebrating today with Sister Betty Brown, who has received the Humanitarian Award at Houston Methodist Hospital. This award is given to the employee who has shown kindness, who have been in assistance to both patients and co-workers. So we celebrate today Sister Betty Brown for her award, the Humanitarian Award for Houston Methodist Hospital.
Amen.
So please, ma'am, please, sir, bring in and your things that you are accomplishing so we can lift you before the Lord in prayer. Thank you.
tomorrow morning we end our prayer and fasting. I said tomorrow morning. I know people are struggling with whether it ends today or tomorrow. It ends tomorrow morning. You actually break your fast. You actually break your fast Monday morning. You actually break. Today is the last day. Hopefully you've been enjoying the book, Fix My Prayer Life. You've been doing your daily reading. Now don't lay this book aside. Go back and pick it up and review and look at it again and chew on it again, because it's been a blessing to those who have been reading and studying and meditating. We've spent 21 days, and it's an awesome thing when a corporate group of people spend 21 days reading the same word every single day.
All right.
And studying the same scriptures every single day.
Amazing.
And praying prayers at the same time during the day, and sometime during the day. It's an awesome thing when we bombard heaven.
Yes.
And we're looking forward to God doing great things. And for somebody, you can testify today, God has done a great thing in my life during these 21 days.
Yes. Yes.
You see, sometimes prayer changes the circumstances.
Yes.
Other times, prayer changes the person that's praying. Amen? You see, we pray, Lord, get me out of this storm. Sometimes God calms the storm.
Yes. Yes.
But many times God calms the child in the midst of the storm.
Yes.
So God knows what's best for us, and God knows what we need. So go back and look at Fix My Prayer Life and go through it again and again, and watch what God does. Watch what God does. Ashi, thank you for sharing the musical platform with my big brother. Thank you so much, man. Thank you for making him feel welcome. Thank you for not telling that's not my continue. Thank you, man, for being so cordial. Thank you so much.
Amen.
Sophia, thank you. Thank you, Sophia. Let's thank Ashi and Sophia for being such an awesome and amazing musicians. Thank you so much. Big brother, thank you, man. Thank you. Thank you for coming through. Thank you for being a part of our service. I want you to come back and have the final words and say hello to us. If you have given anything during the year of 2021, see Sister Whitlock to get your statement. See Sister Whitlock to get your statement. If you've given anything during the year of 2021, see Sister Whitlock to get your statement from the New Beginning Church. Here now, my brother, Pastor Eric Miller.
God bless your heart. Whatever time we had in the Lord,
yes,
amen. Continue to pray for my family, amen. Just Bell's family, just pray for us. Even during these new eras that we're going in, I truly was blessed today. Again, as Pastor was saying, I thank all of you, the musicians, for accompanying me and just being in this hour. I thank my brother for this opportunity. Don't know if I'm going to see you again, but it's been good right here.
Right now.
Amen. Hey, if you pray, hey, eyes have not seen. 21 day fast. My Lord, and this may not be script, but pray for them Kansas City Chiefs too. I'm sorry. Let's go to God in prayer. Amen. For our benediction, pray. Thank you. Father, we thank you now for your spirit, for your anointing in this place. Let your spirit fall upon us. Our minds, our hearts belongs to you. This day, Father, let us walk now in the spirit, pastors, green pastors, restoring our soul instead. And as we speak in the name of Jesus, that the power of God will go forth. Oh Lord, I say, bless everyone with a special blessing in this place. Dismiss us now from this place, but never from thy presence. To the Lord, ask God. Let us say amen.
Amen.
God has spoken. Let the church say amen. Thank you.